Welcome back to Getting Started with Particle Illusion. In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at the fantastic fluid dynamics feature introduced in Particle Illusion 2022. Fluid dynamics is a simulation of the way gases and liquids flow and swirl as they move, and it enables you to add this kind of natural fluid-like motion to your particle simulations. So I've gone ahead and set up a scene where we have an emitter just shooting a burst of particles out. And fluid dynamics are a property of force objects, so we have to start by adding a force object to the stage, just by clicking on the force button up here at the top. And only the particles within the force area are affected, so I'm just going to change the size of this just to encompass the entire stage. And if we just play this back, you're not going to see anything other than the particles being pushed to the right because fluid dynamics hasn't been enabled yet and we have a strength of 100 and the arrow is pointing to the right by default. So what we have to do to create the fluid force is come over to the left here and click Enable Fluid Dynamics. And you can instantly see the difference. Let's play that back. So when the particles enter the force area, they become part of the simulation. If we set strength to 0 for the force, let's just play this back. The simulation is only using the initial velocity of the particles, so everything's moving a little more slowly. So the fluid motion comes from the particle's own velocity, or weight, and also by the action of the forces on the particles, including the fluid's force object. And something to mention is that you can only have one fluid's force object. So if you've got multiple forces on your stage, you can only allocate one of them as the fluid dynamics force. So only particles that are within the force area are affected. So if we make this a little smaller, watch what happens, especially with this high strength. Particles on this side won't be affected, and particles will get pushed through, and as they exit the force, they'll no longer be affected. So you get a fairly obvious delineation between the particles inside, affected by the fluid, and the particles outside. I'm just going to change that back to encompass the entire stage, and the force type can also influence the look of the simulation. So we've got a standard force here, standard box force. What happens if we change this to a box grid? Well, at the moment, all of the arrows are pointing in the same direction, but if we change the direction variation, just crank that up, you can see it's already changing that simulation. And if we change the strength, that's going to push particles in different directions and give you a different look. We also have the sphere type. Going to make that a little larger. And at its default settings, the sphere type force attracts particles towards the center. Let's really crank up this strength. Now, this is obviously a strong directional emitter, but you can see how some of the particles are being drawn backwards. And the sphere force could be really good for these kind of down the drain looks. So play around with the different force types and different strength values to give you different looks. I'm just going to bring this back to a box and just take my strength back to 100. And let's take a look at the fluid parameters. Now we only have three parameters, viscosity, swirling, and simulation detail. And let's look at simulation detail first because this is probably the setting that changes the look of the particles most dramatically. 16 is the default setting. And 16 is faster to calculate, but gives you less detail. It gives you more of these big sweeping looks. 32 is a little bit more render intensive, but it's a good compromise between detail and speed, and it's probably the one you'll use most of the time. And 64 is the highest detail option, but it's the slowest to calculate. Now you can see we have even more detail in there. Let's just bring this back to 16 for now and talk about swirling. Now, swirling adds interference into the flow, and it's more important with these kind of single emitter scenes with no other emitters or forces to introduce any swirling. The default is 30. And generally, you'll probably leave it at this setting most of the time. Let's take this down to 0. You can see, basically, other than this fan at the front, really not much is happening to that simulation. Let's double it to 60. Now we get really obvious swirling. Now, viscosity controls the thickness of the fluid. So a setting of 1 would be more like water. And if we crank this up, let's make this 10. You can see how the particles are having more of a struggle to push through the liquid. So this would be more like oil. So the look of your simulation will depend on the combination of these 3 parameters, and the forces that you have in the scene and their settings, and also how many emitters you have in the scene. Let's bring viscosity back to 1, and we'll take swirling back to 30. I'm going to come down and just enable this other emitter, just by choosing enable from the hamburger menu. And just play that one back. So because the fluid simulation is controlled by the force object, adding emitters together combines their motion automatically. Might just increase the velocity of that one. Very nice. Let's just also come back and we'll just increase the simulation detail. You can see how responsive particle illusion is in this 2022 version. Very nice. Now, when you are using multiple emitters, we just come back and click on the second one here. You'll notice that under the emitter settings is a new effect fluids parameter. So if we increase the green one to 200, you can see that now has more influence in the simulation and starts to push the other emitter back. So you can fine-tune how much influence each emitter has over the particle simulation by adjusting the effect fluid setting. Something else to note is that fluid dynamics also works in 2D. If we switch this across to 2D, it has a flatter appearance. What I might do is just bring this back to 100. It has a flatter appearance, but it also renders faster. And if we click on the fluid force, notice under simulation detail, we don't have 16. We start at 32 and we go all the way up to 256. So you can have more detail in your simulation. And that's obvious there when I change that to 256. So if you don't need 3D and you'd like to have more detail, then maybe go 2D instead. Very nice. Now, before we finish, I just want to mention another great new feature introduced in Particle Illusion 2022, and that's library scenes. I'm just going to come up and choose New Project, and also just change this to Load Layout Create. And notice down here in the preset list, we have Emitters 2022. And underneath that, there's these new emitters with a plus sign. These are actually full Particle Illusion scenes, which contain multiple emitters and forces already set up. These were expertly created by Alan Lawrence, and it'll give you a great idea about the kinds of things that you can do with the new fluid dynamics feature. Okay, so thanks for watching. Remember, you can download Particle Illusion Standalone for free, which includes thousands of free particle emitter presets at borisfx.com, where you can also learn more about the plugin version of Particle Illusion with features including built-in Mocha motion tracking, After Effects light and 3D layer tracking, and emitters on text and masks, all at borisfx.com.